I want to talk about a thing I call the curse of the second verse.
Help me.
Now, we talked a bit yesterday about building the boxes and making the story keep getting better and, you know, and all that. But what I want to talk about now is some templates that might help you with writing the rest of the song. So it's not just, I call it the curse of the second verse because it has this little hooky deal to it, but it's really the curse of the second verse, the bridge, the third verse, the back half of the song. So really this conversation is about once you have a verse and a chorus, assuming there is a chorus in the song, and how that stuff can tell you what you need to write from there conceptually. It's not going to be specifically write each lyric for you, but you always have choices, and I just want to outline these for you. And you know, one of them, one choice you have is the situation where you're broadening the metaphor, where the first verse works and sets up and allows you to do a second verse that isn't so literally connected to the first verse. And so we did one yesterday, I'll do it again for this period here, but the notion of this song called Michelangelo that starts with, I saw this kid in New York City on 42nd Street using colored chalk on a sidewalk canvas. He was drawing a masterpiece as the crowd gathered round to applaud his work. A policeman came by and he acted like a jerk. He said, this is public property and you've got 5 minutes to erase that thing. And I thought, I'd like to see you go tell that to Michelangelo. Now tell him he can paint his little picture, but don't paint on the ceiling. Hey, don't really let your feelings show. I'd like to see you go tell that to Michelangelo. So where'd that come from? I was in New York. I saw this kid, maybe 12, 13, 14 years old, drawing in chalk on the sidewalk around Times Square. There were like 40 or 50 people watching him. He was really good. And at some point, this cop came from out of nowhere and made him hose down, actually, the work he'd been doing for 2 hours, because there's a law on the books that says you cannot draw on the sidewalk. So this song started the seed of this song. Every song we write, I think, has some kind of a reason for being, why you'd write it in the first place. This song started at my ire at like what I had witnessed, like, hey, whoa, what are you doing that for, you know? And that's where the first verse came, and it wrote itself pretty easily. Was there a Michelangelo standing around there? No, I invented that to use as a representative master in the arts of like, this kid might be the next Michelangelo. It could have been, you know, a lot of other people, but certainly a well-known figure, you know. And so every bone in my body kind of wanted to go in the second verse and do a model that we'll talk about later, which is picking up the story where it left off.